Welcome to Implementing Hybrid Scenarios with Office 365 and SharePoint Server 2013. This is Module 2.3, Hybrid Environment Infrastructures. The content provided in these modules is intended for organizations who are currently using SharePoint Server 2013 on-premises, have evaluated the benefits and capabilities of SharePoint Online, are interested in a hybrid SharePoint solution, and would like to learn more about the considerations necessary when planning a hybrid deployment. This module provides an overview of the hybrid environment infrastructure in a hybrid SharePoint deployment. This section in Module 2.3, Hybrid Environment Infrastructure, provides an overview of configuring the on-premises SharePoint environment. The basic steps to configuring the on-premises environment in preparation of the hybrid infrastructure include meeting the basic single sign-on deployment requirements, configuring SharePoint 2013 services, and lastly, configuring SharePoint 2013 for inbound requests. When you set up and enable single sign-on, users in your organization are able to use their corporate credentials to access the Office 365 offerings. This removes the burden of managing multiple logon identities and passwords. Without single sign-on, an Office 365 user would have to maintain separate usernames and passwords. For an even better end-user experience, you can create and deploy smart links. They can help speed up user sign-in requests by reducing the number of redirects necessary for authentication. In addition to the user benefits, there are also considerable benefits to administrators and your organization. For example, configuring single sign-on also helps you to enforce your organization's password policies and account restrictions in both your on-premises Active Directory and Office 365 directory. To prepare, you must make sure that your environment meets the basic single sign-on requirements and verify that your Active Directory in Windows Azure Active Directory tenant is set up in a way that's compatible with single sign-on requirements. You must have Active Directory deployed and running in either Windows Server 2003 R2, Windows Server 2008, Windows Server 2008 R2, Windows Server 2012, or Windows Server 2012 R2 with a functional level of mixed or native. If you plan to use Active Directory Federation services as your security token service, you'll need to do one of the following. Download and install and deploy Active Directory Federation services 2.0 on a Windows Server 2008 or Windows Server 2008 R2 server. And also, if users will be connecting from outside your company's network, you must deploy an ADFS 2.0 proxy and install the ADFS role service on a Windows Server 2012 or Windows Server 2012 R2 server. In addition, Active Directory must have certain settings configured in order to work properly with single sign-on. In particular, the user principal name, also known as a user logon name, must be set up in a specific way for each user. You also need to configure the user profile service to synchronize user and group profiles from your on-premises Active Directory domain. When federated users access resources in a hybrid environment, the STS service makes calls to the user profile service to obtain user account metadata, such as the UPN and email property values. This metadata is used by the STS service to construct security tokens during the authentication process. SharePoint Online presents claims to the on-premises SharePoint farm using the Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, or otherwise SMTP. To support this, you need to ensure that the SharePoint user profiles for all federated users are populated with the user's email address by using the correct UPN. This means that the work email field in the on-premises SharePoint user profile store needs to contain their federated email address. For example, if a federated user logs into the on-premises domain as adventureworks/KarenB, and the public domain for the hybrid environment is adventureworks.com, then their federated email address is KarenB@adventureworks.com. You have to verify that the App Management and Microsoft SharePoint Foundation subscription setting services are started and configured. These services must be enabled to support certain configuration procedures and to provide support to register SharePoint Online as a high-trust app in SharePoint 2013. If your hybrid environment is configured for an inbound authentication topology, you must also ensure that a single on-premises web application is configured to receive requests from SharePoint Online. This web application is referred to as the primary web application for your SharePoint environment. This step describes how to configure the primary web application to accept requests from the external endpoint URL. No specific web application configuration is required to support a one-way outbound authentication topology. In a SharePoint 2013 hybrid environment, outbound connections can be made from any on-premises web application. A single SharePoint 2013 web application must be configured for inbound connections and is used as the primary web application for accepting inbound connections and configuring services and connection objects for the hybrid features you deploy. You can either create a new web application and site collection or configure an existing web application for this purpose. This section in Module 2.3, Hybrid Environment Infrastructure, provides an overview of configuring the SharePoint Online environment. Your choice of an authentication topology determines how you'll configure certificates and the capabilities of your hybrid solution. A one-way outbound hybrid authentication topology enables hybrid service integration in one direction only. In this topology, your on-premises SharePoint 2013 farm can consume content and resources from your Office 365 tenant. For example, search can be configured to allow federated users to see both local and remote search results in a SharePoint 2013 search portal, but only local results are available in the SharePoint Online search portal. A one-way outbound hybrid topology can only be used for outbound search solutions. A one-way outbound topology does not support hybrid solutions for business connectivity services, SAP with Duet Enterprise Online, or bidirectional search. A one-way inbound hybrid topology enables SharePoint Online to connect to SharePoint Server 2013 through a reverse proxy device. For example, users of a SharePoint Online search portal can see both local and remote search results, but only local results are available in the SharePoint Server 2013 search portal. A one-way topology can be configured to let your users access on-premises SharePoint search results from the internet, as long as they have a connection to the intranet through a virtual private network or direct access. A two-way topology enables bidirectional hybrid service integration between your on-premises SharePoint 2013 environment and your Office 365 tenant. For example, search can be configured to allow federated users to see both local and remote search results in either SharePoint 2013 or the SharePoint Online search portals. A two-way hybrid topology can be configured to let your users access on-premises search results from the internet as long as they have access to the intranet through a virtual private network or direct access. SharePoint Online presents claims to the on-premises SharePoint farm by using the simple mail transfer protocol. To support this, you need to ensure that the SharePoint user profiles for all federated users are populated with the user's email address by using the correct UPN. Again, this would mean that the work email field in the on-premises SharePoint user profile store needs to contain their federated email address. For example, if that federated user logs into the on-premises domain as adventureworks/KarenB and the public domain for the hybrid environment is adventureworks.com, then their federated email address would be KarenB@adventureworks.com. When you configure SharePoint Online for a hybrid environment that provides search or business connectivity services functionality, you must first acquire a secure channel certificate. Then you must create and configure a target application in the Secure Store Service application in SharePoint Online to store the certificate and to enable it to be used by SharePoint Online services. This target application is referred to as the Secure Channel Target App. The five steps provided in this slide are designed to help show how to create the Secure Channel Target App in SharePoint Online. This section in Module 2.3, Hybrid Environment Infrastructure, provides an overview of configuring a reverse proxy device. SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online can be configured in a hybrid configuration to securely combine search results and external data from Microsoft Business Connectivity Services and Duet Enterprise. Reverse proxy devices play a role in the secure configuration of a hybrid SharePoint 2013 deployment when inbound traffic from SharePoint Online needs to be relayed to your on-premises SharePoint 2013 farm. For example, if a federated user uses a SharePoint Online search portal that is configured to return hybrid search results, a reverse proxy device intercepts and pre-authenticates the request for on-premises SharePoint 2013 content, and then relays it to SharePoint 2013. The reverse proxy device in a hybrid topology provides a secure endpoint for inbound traffic using SSL encryption and client certificate authentication. In a hybrid SharePoint 2013 scenario, the reverse proxy must be able to support client authentication with a wildcard or SAN SSL certificate, support pass-through authentication for OAuth 2.0, including unlimited OAuth bearer token transactions, and accept unsolicited inbound traffic on TCP port 443. No ports other than TCP 443 need to be opened on the external reverse proxy endpoint to support hybrid connectivity. Hybrid SharePoint environments support a number of reverse proxy devices. The basic steps include configuring ADFS, importing an SSL certificate, and configuring the published application. This section, in Module 2.3, Hybrid Environment Infrastructure, provides an overview of configuring server-to-server trust. There are 7 basic steps to configuring server-to-server trust. To service incoming server-to-server requests from another SharePoint 2013 farm, you must configure the SharePoint 2013 farm to trust the sending farm. Use the Windows PowerShell commandlet, new SP Trusted Security Token Issuer in SharePoint 2013 to configure the trust relationship by specifying the JavaScript object notation metadata endpoint of the sending farm. You can also configure an STS for HTTP. However, the recommended best practice for server-to-server authentication is to use SSL and an HTTPS-based URL to send and receive requests. Also, the recommended best practice for server-to-server authentication is that each server-to-server authentication application that establishes trust with a SharePoint farm must use a different certificate. In a cross-farm SharePoint topology, if you have to use the same certificate across farms, you have to also set the identifier of the SharePoint Security Token Service to be the same across those farms. When SharePoint 2013 is installed, the Security Token Service of the on-premises SharePoint farm creates a default certificate to validate incoming tokens. You must replace the default STS certificate on each farm server with either a certificate issued by a public certification authority that is trusted by Windows Azure Active Directory or with a self-signed certificate. We recommend using a certificate issued by a public certification authority for production environments to ensure maximum security and because self-signed certificates might have integration issues with other applications and services. Self-signed certificates are best for test and/or pilot deployments. Each domain that you want to federate must either be added as a single sign-on domain or converted to be a single sign-on domain from a standard domain. Adding or converting a domain sets up a trust between ADFS and Windows Azure Active Directory. If you are using a subdomain, such as corp.contoso.com, in addition to a top-level domain, such as contoso.com, you must add the top-level domain in your cloud service before you add any subdomains. When the top-level domain is set up for single sign-on, all subdomains are automatically set up as well. Setting up a trust is a one-time operation, and you do not need to run the Windows Azure Active Directory module for Windows PowerShell commandlets again if you add more ADFS servers to your server farm. If you add and verify a domain with the Windows Azure Active Directory module, you need to also specify several additional settings. These settings are required so that you can see the DNS records that you must configure to enable your domain to work with your cloud service. If you need to support multiple top-level domains, you must use the Support Multiple Domain switch with any commandlets. To validate that the configuration is successful, use the Get MSOL Federation Property commandlet. The Get MSOL Federation Property commandlet gets key settings from both the ADFS server and Microsoft Online Services. You can use this information to troubleshoot authentication problems caused by mismatched settings between the ADFS server and Microsoft Online Services. Adding a service principal name to your Azure Active Directory tenant is necessary to support mutual authentication between SharePoint 2013 and a SharePoint Online tenant. The SPN is comprised of the SharePoint Online principal object in your company's public DNS namespace. The basic syntax for the SPN is service type slash instance name, where the service type is the SharePoint Online principal object, which is the same for all SharePoint Online tenants, and the instance name is the URL of your company's public DNS domain namespace, which is always expressed as a wildcard, even if the Secure Channel SSL certificate is a SAN certificate. The set MSOL service principal commandlet updates a service principal in Windows Azure Active Directory. It can be used to update the display name, enable and disable the service principal trusted for delegation, or the service principal names or the addresses. The register spapp principal commandlet is used to enable an on-premises or SharePoint Online administrator to register an app principal. You can also use the new SP Azure Access Control Service Application Proxy commandlet to create a new service application proxy group for the Azure Control Service application. Module 2.3, Hybrid Environment Infrastructure, provided an overview of the basic hybrid infrastructure and functional considerations of a hybrid SharePoint environment, including the basic requirements for configuring server-to-server trust and additional considerations. Module 2.4 Next provides an overview of server-to-server trust and authentication for a hybrid SharePoint environment.